international podcast.
Well, thanks for the info. That's good. 411.
Maybe we'll see it tonight.
A little bit of Spanish. Usually he speaks in Quechua. So Carmita is going to translate some of the questions you have and the conversation we're going to have because he understands just a little bit of Spanish, okay? So first, one of the things you're going to see at the first view is the eyes, of course. His job, as you saw in the video, is one of the hardest jobs, I think. These days, no one else do it anymore because it's more cheaper buy some eyes in a industry of frozen ice then actually bring it from the Chimborazo. This ice doesn't have any chemicals, actually the cleanest ice you can have because it's actually a subterranean ice, bring it from the Chimborazo volcano. So he's gonna talk a little bit about the experience he has. Baltazar, cuéntanos un poquito de su experiencia, por favor.
Este es mi trabajo. Este es mi trabajo desde 15 años. Desde 15 años, ese es mi trabajo. Hielo de Chimborazo, hielo natural. Este, bajo de la tierra sacando, destapando tierra, piedra, destapando. Por dentro sacamos con pico, con barra, hacha y lampa. Ese trabajo peligroso, trabajo duro, ese trabajo de hombre es.
So he's saying that from 15 years old, he started this activity. It's one of the hardest jobs. Because you have to take the ice from inside, actually, of the mountain. It's not the ice that you saw covering the mountain, it's actually under ice. This job is pretty hard, you saw it on the video, the tools he used actually to take him out.
Does he still go and cut ice?
Yes,
even now?
He is. Síganos contando.
Ese hielo me aguanta hasta 8 días. Hasta 8 días aguanta ese hielo envuelto con pajita. Hueco de chera y portadeta hasta 8 días, a veces que pasa también. Este hielo duro, hielo natural. Este, lo que es este más grande, tiene 45 libras, 50 libras. Ese me paga soldado de Riobamba cada lote $5. $5 paga cada lote.
So he's saying that usually this ice can preserve as an ice for 8 days. How they conserve that? So they cover it with the straw that you see here, and also they make a hole in the earth. So they put the ice inside, covered by the straw, and covering the hole, and they can maintain this ice 8 days. Now, usually when he go to the volcano to take out the ice, he has blocks of 45 pounds, 50 pounds, and he usually bring it from the mountain and take it to the markets. How much they pay for these blocks?
$5.
For a block of 45 pounds or 50 pounds.
Yo he trabajado desde 15 años. Desde 15 años. Antes trabajaba con mami, con papi, con amigos. 5 grupos, 6 grupos. Cada grupo 15 burritos, 12 burritos. Andábamos cuando no había hielo de África antes. Bastante habíamos trabajado antes. Yo andaba con mami, con papi, con hermano, andábamos antes. Mi papi era como teta chimbo, cabecita blanco, pelo blanco, era mi papi. Sí, era mi papi. Antes bastante sabíamos. A veces que un solo día sabíamos hacer 2 viajes.
Oh my
So he's saying that usually the work he made was with a lot of friends. Usually 5-6 friends that used to go and go out, more than 11-12 donkeys. Now he do it by his own. Usually he learned this from his father. One of the legends we have in Ecuador is that when a person or a baby born and has the skin very clear, white, blonde eye, the eyes are very clear, usually that is a genetic problem, you can say. But when that happened, as a legend in Ecuador says that when a baby born like that, it's because it's son of the Chimborazo. Because Chimborazo made the mother having that baby, because it's so white. Now, his father was one of that one. So actually, Baltazar is a family of the Chimborazo. And he actually make this job in this mountain, his family.
How
far does he have to climb? Yes, he's going to
say
yes. How far does he have to get to the ice? He's going to climb to get to the ice. I know what they want. I salgo 7 de la mañana de la casa. A llegar mena de lo, 4 horas caminamos, andamos con piedra. Parte montando correcto, parte con piedra, andábamos. Sí, lo me hoteleza para fresco, para jugo, para helado, para eso me hoteleza. Pero ahora ellos mismos tienen hielo de abrega, por eso me pide, poquito no me pide. Antes cuando no había hielo de abrega, ahí sí, bastante sabía pedir antes. Hasta ningún día sabía llevar el camión grande, porque soldados a la volante, al tiempo, al tambor, sabía llevar antes. Aquí soldados de bomba mismo, casan andando, camión grande, sabían repartiendo, entregar antes.
Part of the trabajo que hace Baltazar is quite interesting to get the idea that the world is mean, because usually he spent a lot of hours to go in there. How much hours? It's 4 hours in total. He doing this walking and also by the donkey some of the parts. Of course, when they put the eyes on the donkey, he do the rest walking again. So it's 4 hours going up and 4 hours going down. The day of him starts at 7 o'clock and he usually finish, as you can tell, in afternoon. Usually he takes the blocks of ice to the markets. He usually used to take it even to Ambato. But now he's doing only to Riobamba, and he do this activity 2 days per week. He starts sometimes Thursday, Friday, or sometimes Friday and Saturday to bring the ice down, and they sell it. Usually depends how the ladies on the market buy the ice and tell to him how many blocks they want. So usually it's 5-4 blocks. Imagine a few years ago used to be at least 10. He used to actually fill a whole truck with the blocks to sell it on the market. Now he just go down 4 or 5, which is almost nothing. And he only earns $5 for each block, so you can imagine how much he earns per month. He do this every single week, so you can have an idea how much money he receives.
Lo hemos visto hasta en este momento. Así que conocemos que Baltazar hace un trabajo duro, es un trabajo único ahora en nuestro país, así que les pido un aplauso.
Para yeah,